Alright, y'all, this is me once again trying this new out. I'm taking you to Spectacle Island, which is the largest build area on the wasteland world that I know of, but it's a pain in the ass. There's a lot of clearing up to do, and there's two ways to actually do this mission. You can either go through and individually kill a bunch of creatures, or you can do a quick way, and it's more, I'm going to go ahead and show you the quickest way to do this, so hang in there and we'll get this done. The quickest way to go, you'll see a little still part like a trailer almost with a loudspeaker right next to it. And then you go on in here, you'll find the workbench right there. And there's a little note here. Read it. Give you a few seconds. And then you can click that, but nothing will happen. What you need to do is you need to follow these wire lines to this little ship over here. And just a heads up, when you do this, you'll have the Mylar screen pop up with a bunch of other enemies. But you don't have to fight them, you can actually avoid them. So here we are, you click that open, turn it on, and all the monsters start coming. Now their teeth just open up behind me. So you just race on by, ignore all other enemies. I'll fight them, whatever you choose to do. I prefer to do this at the moment because in the aspect of saving time. And then you come around here and then you activate the switch again. A loud whine will start up and it totally goes up the way you can't hear it no more. And it chases all the... Well, it looks like we got a glitch here. Well, it's a good thing I prepared just in case. Yeah, you better run. Okay, back to the big boy. Where's the mama jama? My crazy got his ass handed to him. Is she still within range? No, it's here. Ah, there she is. Now let's try this with a little bit of range between me and the explosion. Woo! By the way, that's with the Merv. It's multiple fat boys in one shot. Oh, she survived. Ooh, that hurt. So let's say that's not a good idea. So we go for round two. As you can see, with the siren going still, which is still going even though we can't hear it, the Myrlites still aren't attacking. Okay. By the way, you'll find a bunch of corpses. Just loot them all. Like I said, you get a lot of good stuff here. Like right there, I just got four keys and cores and whatnot. Most likely later we'll come back and clean that up more. But, well, once we get this done, I'll do TCL, which is Cargo Conclusion Awe. Conclusion, basically you can fly like a ghost. Workshop mode, and as I said, there is a lot of cleanup to do, so I'm going to go ahead and pause this video, and once it's all done, I will start it back up. Hey guys, I'm back again. We finally did a little bit of clear up. I wanted to go ahead and go do the TCL right fast so that you can see the actual scope of Spectral Island. When I said there was a lot of cleanup, I wasn't kidding. Nor was I kidding about the sheer size of it. You can look around. Obviously, you don't need to use settlement build. That green line is your build border. And as you can see, I'm about, let's see. Keep going just a touch more. Alright. This height is the tallest you can build your building, which you can see is taller than anything else on the island, and it's pretty level with the bridges across the way. And there's not a whole lot of flat areas to build on, and a few things in the way, like those canisters that you can't get rid of. Name with but plenty of water for water generation, plenty of land for crops, and just sheer magnitude building. I mean, you can use foundation, both wood and concrete, to do this. So, it is not an exaggeration to say it's a huge build area. So, here we go. Take a look around. And what I want to go ahead and show you to do now is I'm just going to make like a little beach house that kind of gets you a little bit of scopes on the depth of the water and size you can make, and then I'll do another toggle and you can see how big it is in comparison. So this one I am going to use concrete foundation, which I prefer as to use concrete. There's a lot better choices, a lot better clicks for connection and whatnot. I'm going to make this one 8x8. Maybe we'll just do 6x6. That's a little bit more reasonable. Much more than that, just too much. Let's make sure. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And I'm gonna go ahead and do one more row this way. And I also, once I finish doing this last tier, which I just finished, I will show you how to make a more consecutive build, so that the clicks aren't such a hassle to deal with. As you can see here, you make sure everything's facing in the same direction, so that all the clicks are in the facing the same way as well. Otherwise, you could have some conflicts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, we got the base done now. Damn, McCready always has to get in the way. Move, McCready. And I also, for the first floor, will use concrete walls. For me, that my friends used to joke around calling Bethesda Glitch rather than Bethesda Studios, because they always release their games with some kind of glitch. Now, one of the greatest things about a concrete build that I love is the fact that you can take and literally stack your build. So you can make multiple floors in one go. I wouldn't go any more than two tiers out. Later videos will have timelines for you to just skip ahead for specific things if that's what you're tuning in for, such as electric alignment, structure consistency, and submersion, so on and so forth, or technical babble, which there won't be too much of that with me. I can't really change game words into real words. I'm not kind of like Mr. Matty Plays or Markiplier and a few others. Gopher's especially really good at that. And if you don't know these names that I just listed off, also when I figure it out, there will be links to them, because a lot of my work is inspired by videos I've watched from them. Especially Markiplier, Matty Plays, Gopher, and a few others like IGN Spot. Doors. Being at the beach house framework I'm working on, it will be double doors. Cause who know? You know, if I had the money, I'd definitely have a grandiose house on the beach. What I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to go to the wood prefab, because these are my favorite ones for the balcony. That's not going to work. So we'll just use the basic wood framework. Alright. Do the same and go to the quarter walls, because they look like actually stone pillars. And you got that new contraption, so yeah, I know. Which I haven't checked that DLC out yet, but I'm intending on doing it when I can. Now, as far as when you're actually doing this part, you can do it several different ways. You can use these grates here, which actually let you look down into the water. Or you can use this floor, which gives you more of a sense. We'll do this one here then. Keep in mind, even though you can't really tell when you got sideways, the steel fencing is very kind of shady looking. It's all bent and whatnot. So that may, if you have a problem putting it on, that may be where it's deriving from. As you can see, it kind of slightly curves in. Okay, this works. Next thing I will do, I will take those out, and then I will go up here and choose the gates to put in. And the reason why I'm doing that will become clear momentarily. Get it to line up proper. There we go. And yeah, you got a little gap here, but you're not going to get perfection, unfortunately. That's just the way it is. I mean, you can take and mess it around like so, but when you line one thing up, especially when you're using the basic scrap, is what it is, scrap fencing, you're going to throw off your alignment with other stuff like that. See how you got a big old gap right now forming, and you do this. See how it does that? Yeah. So it's advisable just to do the best you can with what you got to work with. Okay, now the reason why I'm using these, let's see if I can actually fix it a little bit. I think I know what I need to do. Yeah, no, I just got done saying don't do it, but At times I'm very OCD about how my stuff looks. I hate stuff being unaligned. Yeah, I like that better. Maybe a little bit off, but it's a lot better than it was. Okay, what you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna wanna escape from the build area for the moment. And go ahead and open up your gates. The two reasons why you do this is when you have your NPCs actually using them, or yourself, you need the gates to be opened correctly. Otherwise, it's going to end up just causing all kinds of glitches and mess ups. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is, this is where we will go back to the wood floors. And we're gonna make kind of like a little sit down area. For fish. Yeah, there we go. Now you can either close this off, get the tendency R, your NPC may actually fall off into the water. If they're not set up right, which is any mods you may create or any actual things in the Bethesda game, vanilla game, because the settlement building seemed to me to be a very much of an afterthought, and they weren't really mapped properly to follow through any new additions you make, especially if you're using mods. So keep that in mind. For me, I'm just going to go ahead and leave it open. And then I'm going to go here to some chairs, some decorations, and we're going to put out some chairs for fishing. Over this way. Also, keep in mind when you set your furniture, the earlier statement I made, because if you want to use it, or if you want your NPCs to use it and make it look like they're actually doing it, you're going to want to have it set up where they can actually sit in the chairs like they do on the prefab settlements made by Bethesda game developers. We'll go ahead and use the steel chairs right here. Now, I'm fixing to go ahead and do another completely cosmetic thing. You can do it or not do it. I mean, it's all up to you. But I'm going to use these little tool chests here to make it look like kind of like a tackle box. And when I get fishing rods later, I'll set those up as well. Okay, so you got your first tier done, which is very basic framework. You know, you can do it with anything here. And now you gotta decide, where are you gonna put your stairs to go to your second floor, if you're gonna have a second floor? Well, as you saw earlier, I made it deliberately for a second floor. This is where another key factor goes in. When you go to make your floors, you will need to pick an area and clear it. Because, at least for my build style, because my preferred stairs for the second floor are actually the wood prefab, and it's this one. You also want to have it far enough away from the walls, so when you're actually using them, or your NPCs are using them, they don't just, like, walk blindly into the wall like so. Hence why I put it 2 back. Also, that's another reason why you should make your houses anywhere from 3 to 4 width, other than the simplicity of the roof. Alright, now, as you can see, also, by doing this here, this connects perfectly. So you don't have to mess around with trying to adjust for a floor and whatnot. In this area, we're going to make just a simple, we're going to use the wood for it, which is the logical thing to do, because as you get higher up, you want softer material, lighter material, so everything doesn't collapse in on itself. Like, I mean, as far as logistics, I mean, for me, that's really what it's all about, especially now that VR is coming out, and from what I understand, everything from Fallout 3 up will be VR compatible. And if I'm wandering around in VR in my builds, I'd be really annoyed at myself if I break my own submersion by not doing simple, quick setups like so. I mean, it doesn't take long, and it's really quick and easy most times. Okay, we got that floor done. Now, this is where I was telling you about earlier about using walls and stuff like this, and that's why you want to use the second storage floor, because as you can see, you can actually click, for the most part, get it to fit. If you have like the roof and a floor, it makes it much harder to set up rooms. And it is going to be like kind of a rich man's playhouse, so I will do my best to actually make it look like so. Dude, if you seem to have problems with that, just pick an area like so and just clear it out. And build around it later. There we go, much better. Don't be afraid to experiment with your build, because you never know, you may actually create something that is far superior than what you originally thought you were gonna do. If you decide that, any of you guys decide you'd like to listen to something else, I'm open for suggestions. Though, don't be surprised if I choose not to do certain music, because I'm not a fan of them. Not putting anything down, it's just, it's just how I feel. Let's try the ropes then. Back to the floor. Another reason why you can use this floor, and it's not going to be too bad when you get gaps like that there, it's because you can, I'll show you momentarily or in a bit on how to work with that. Okay, that looks like the best we're going to be able to do with that. Okay, this is why I said not to worry about it, because Another great thing about Bethesda, so not all of them really match too much. Like, for instance, if you were to use that, it doesn't really match decor. But you can go to the wood fab and use this one here, which is one I use. I mean, you can tell the difference in how it looks, but at the same time, it's not too bad. Okay, now these gaps you see here, another reason why I said not to worry too much about it, it's because you can use these smaller frames here, usually, not always, but usually to fill the gaps up. And if you find that it's being a hassle, then you just remove the pieces that you've already set up and reframe it. Like so. Yeah, I know. I was going on and on about submersion and how it breaks by this and that. But if you think about it, don't we really do that in real life as well as in most video games you play? We adapt. I mean, if I have a house and it's just a slight bit too small, I don't have the money to completely remodel a house, so I settle for what I can. That's pretty much the exact same case here. Okay, now we got this done. We got the four rooms down here. Like I said, I'm not going to go no higher than three tiers on this one. For this one, we're actually going to make an open dining deck, which I will again use the stone, the wood prefab for this, just to do. Yeah, we'll use this one. Yeah, I know it's a door. You'll see in a minute how it works. Using this style of roof, not for any specific reason, no preference or anything like that. I just like the feel of it, the look of it. Whoops. Okay, now you remember how I promised you this would look like there's a reason for that? Here, I'll show you how to do that. There's multiple ways you can do this. You can use fencing like this, solid fence like that, or fence like this. I'd rather not use that, but you can. What I'm gonna use, and I will use that one. Okay, we got that done. Now, as I said, we got all the framework done. Going down here, around here. We'll get the doors in later. I just choose not to put them right now because they'd be in the way. Okay, now McCarty sent him a while ago, but he seemed to still be insisting on being in the way. The one thing I do dislike about the followers for this game is they have a tendency of being more of a nuisance than an addition. Though, at least this time around, the story was actually really well done for the followers. Let me see how that looks. Hmm. Another thing you got to be cautious with if you haven't discovered it yet while you're in the settlement build, is you got to be very careful how you build. Because unfortunately, as you can see, the scenery does not change for your structures. It actually gets in the way quite often when you're trying to build something. Horrible, but that's one thing you needed to do better. If you ever make a game if you make another game in the future, remember that is not a good idea. You need to either, if you're gonna allow build, you need to either have it where it's gonna work and mold around the buildings you're doing, are you needed to be able to adapt. This is not good, Bethesda. This is bad. I don't know how many times I just trashed the build I had just because of the scenery being in the way like that. Because there's no reason for it. If we can create destructible scenery and stuff like that in like any number of games out there, you should be able to make it where the scenery can be manipulated and moved out of the way of a simple build. That's still in the way. Screw it. We're just gonna have to deal. It sucks because stuff like that completely destroyed the submersion, but I'm so far along on this, I'm not gonna sit there and redo everything just because something's stupid. But anyways, back to what I was talking about. Let's see, we got the framework done and everything. We can work on the decoration later. We're going to work on powering it up next. But I just want to give you a little bit of a glimpse with TCL of what you're actually looking at for structure. When I say there's a lot of area to build. Yeah, so you see that three-tier building we just made? Ooh, I gotta fix those roofs. But that three-tier building we made right there? Yeah, that's all it takes. It's that small little corner. And we got all this other area to build on. So, yeah, it gets you plenty of build for later. I'm gonna go ahead and fix these right back. Nah, I'll get to that later off camera. Okay, so, as I said, we're going to get wiring done. So, we could do one of two things. We could create windmills to put on top of that, which, yeah, that'd look tacky. We can just put generators out in the middle of nowhere. Again, tacky, and can easily be destroyed if your settlement gets attacked. Which, even though it doesn't happen often, does happen. So, I will show you my generator build room. It's basically a good size, so we're going to go ahead and make this a 3x2. So we can also get walls in here. Alright. Then we're going to go ahead and build the walls. Just your basic. You can use whatever you want, but this is what I use. On it because it dampens the sound quite a bit. Now, you can either make this accessible or unaccessible, being as you can use console commands. I will be using it as inaccessible. So, but I will make this one dual floor, so I can have, should be 6 or 8 generators, just for this one quick, simple build. And yes, I know it's not necessary to make your wires all connect like that, but it's a redundancy system because when you lose generators, like when they get damaged or blown up or whatever it happens to be, you also lose power. Alright, I'm back. If you take a look at the walls, this is the first wall I did to show you. It's all interconnected. And then it's pretty much the same on all the other sides, as you can see here. And here. And even if we can see it, I'm not quite sure we'll be able to. Yeah, we're gonna have to use TCL. It's all set up. So, if everything's connected correctly, every outlet in here, every piece of wall in here should be lit once you apply lights. We will find that out right now. Alright, you can use any light you want to test, but the ones I usually use are the ceiling ones. Either those are, because they should all light up, you only need one to do your test. And if these parts of the roof lights up, so does that part of the wall. The real challenge is going to be towards the center, like right there. You see how you don't got no power? This can be remedied. It's a little more difficult, but if it's necessary, if it's not necessary, don't do it. You know, because it is a hassle, but you also want everything to be lit up. But as you can see, that's lit all the way up to here. This whole area should be lit this whole section. The only section that don't have power is this section. Pretty much right here is the only section that don't have power. It's right in the center. And I'll show you a quick fix on that. But then again, you also don't have power out here either. So this is the quick fix for that. Right here, I did complete the ceiling for this part here, and you'll notice they have the holes in it. So the way we're gonna complete this is actually kinda convoluted, but very simple at the same time. You're gonna take, and if everything's done right, you should be able to place it right about there. And then TCL. Up we go. TCL again. And now that you got that outlet there, you're gonna get this ground outlet here, the bottom one. You're going to place it in two places just to make sure you can reach. There and there. And if you really wanted to, you could do a third. Then you should be able to connect it here, 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 and down there. No, because I put this in the wrong area. Let's try that now. Okay, we're going to use TCL. The word of caution, when you have yourself, you're attached to something, like a wire or a piece of furniture or a wall, you need to be very careful on what you do because it could really screw things up. Just so you know, for it, anytime you decide to use TCL. Okay, it's not going to fit there. Like I said, this is the tricky part. This is where you're going to have to play with it. Because you're technically going through the roof to do this. We'll try this a couple times. If we can't get it to work, we will try this first. And then we'll try to put a wall roof back up there. Yeah, that's what I figured. So what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and put that one away. You can do this, like I said, multiple ways, and don't be afraid to experiment. Like that there. Then you will create another outlet. Here, connected to that one, and then you should be able to implement it throughout this way. Now, make it reach where you previously haven't had power, like when you got those TED zones, because it does have the added advantage to also light up the areas above it without no problem. Alright, now let's try our roof light again. And there we go, we got power there. Here. And then basically you just go around, you test where you got your power and where you don't. And then you connect the wire where you don't. Like right here is a dead zone. So you create another outlet. And there you got your light. Whoops. That just put it on the top floor. That's annoying. Yeah, there you go. And then we need to put another one there. So on and so forth. You just keep running it through. Right now it's just, since we're just doing the skeleton frame, and we haven't done anything else, it's fine to do this so you know exactly where your power is and where it isn't. When you go to start making walls, it's a little more complicated. Alright, looks like we should be fully lit up now. Yeah. Just go ahead and leave that one there. As you can see, remember, this is just a totally empty room. Now, where'd that light get put? There's something right here. And this is where, also in part, why Bethesda uses windows in the structures, even though it seems illogical being radiation storage. But if you can't get your power, you know, you gotta work around with the power with the engine you're given. So, yeah, you need windows at times. Hey, there you go. See? Everything is connected. As you can see. All right. That will wrap it up for this video, and I hope it turns out alright. It's gone a lot longer than I thought it would. So, yeah, if you like, subscribe. If you don't, do whatever, you know, it's on you. If you have any suggestions on what we would do with all these empty areas, I will leave it open for a while and work on another project. Alright, that's it for me, y'all. Sleep well, dream well. And happy wakings. Bye. So I'm hopping on down here to Diamond City. Wonderful little buffet slash bar. All the noodles you can eat. Nuka-Cola, always great. Smoke a cigarette, hang out with the locals. And let's see what the next adventure will bring.